appreciate your message very much, but that wasn't precisely the question. You're the CEO of this campaign.
Asked, how are you going to do it? Which deductions, which loopholes are you going to close? He can't tell you. The fact that he only has to pay 14% on his taxes when a lot of you are paying much higher. You know, he's already taken that off the board. Capital gains are going to continue to be at a low rate. So we're not going to get money that way. Just the energy of today, but also the energy of the future. All those things will make a difference. So the point is, the commitments I've made, I've kept. And those that I haven't been able to keep, it's not for lack of trying, and we're going to get it done in a second term. But you should pay attention to this campaign, because Governor Romney has made some commitments as well. And I suspect he'll keep those too. Now, when members of the Republican Congress say, we're going to sign a no-tax pledge so that we don't ask a dime for millionaires and billions to reduce our deficit so we can still invest in education and helping kids go to college. He said, me too. When they said, we're going to cut Planned Parenthood funding, he said, me too. Philosophy on taxes has been simple, and that is, I want to give middle class families and folks who are striving to get in the middle class some relief, because they have been hit hard over the last decade, over the last 15, over the last 20 years. So 4 years ago, I stood on the stage just like this one. Actually, it was at the town hall, and I said I would cut taxes for middle class families, and that's what I've done, by $3,600. I said I would cut taxes for small businesses who are the drivers and engines of growth. And we've cut them 18 times. And I want to continue those tax cuts for middle class families and for small businesses. If somebody came to you, Governor, with a plan that said, here, I want to spend $7 or $8 trillion, and we're going to pay for it, but we can't tell you until maybe after the election how we're going to do it, you wouldn't have taken such a sketchy deal. Democrat, Republican. First of all, I think it's important to tell you that we did come in during some tough times. We were losing 800,000 jobs a month when I started. But we had been digging our way out of policies that were misplaced and focused on the top doing very well and middle class folks not doing well. Now, we've seen 31 consecutive months of job growth, 5.2 million new jobs created. And the plans that I talked about will create even more.
I was someone who ran businesses for 25 years and balanced the budget. I ran the Olympics and balanced the budget. I ran the state of Massachusetts as a governor, to the extent any governor does, and balanced the budget all 4 years.
Appreciate your message very much, but that wasn't precisely the question.
That's all, folks.